Oh, I worship your name. I bless you, Lord. I bless you, Lord. I bless you, Lord. In the morning, Lord. I bless you, Lord. In the noonday, Lord. I bless you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We bless your name. We give you all the glory. Oh, we worship you. Somebody bless the Lord. Somebody give him praise. Mande Kebosha is a great and mighty God. For there is none like him. Mande Deboshanda. There is none like him. Thank you, Jesus. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I can search throughout eternity, Lord, and find there is no lie. Oh, there is no lie. Somebody sing with me, there is none like you. No one else can touch my life like you do. I have searched you throughout eternity, and I found there is no life. Oh, there is no like you, say. Hallelujah. Oh, there is no like you, Lord. Can't touch my life like you. I have searched you all eternity. And I found there is none. Makale brado say, oh, there is none like you, Lord. There is none. Oh, there is none like you, Lord. Maya na 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 moseke ya the worship. We worship you. I have searched, there is no any other God like you. Hey. And I found there is none. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, there is none like you, Lord. There is none. There is none like my God. There is none like my God. Yes, Lord. Makada ba shata ya na ba ba ba. Makende brege de bo bo bo. Sika ya ne le brege de bo sa. Aya tuale eternity, and I find. Hey. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Oh, there is none like you, Jesus. There is none. Help me sing. There is none like you, none like you. Hey. Oh, there is none like you, Lord, in my life. My Father, the game changer, the barrenness crusher. Yes, Lord. How? Oh, Jesus, there is none. It is only you. It is only you. Only you. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Hey, there is none like you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh yes, makaba lebra bo sekete lebo shanderia. Hey, mm. God. Hey, they are the works of man, but you are. There is none like you, Lord. Ah. Oh, Lord, God. Sing, reaching your heights, raise your voice. But you are. Oh, there is none. Oh, Lord, God. They are the works of man. But you are. You alone. You alone. You alone. You alone. Yes. Somebody raise your voice. Say, oh, Lord, God. They are nothing but nothing, nothing, nothing. But the works of man. Oh, you are. Oh, there is none like you. Hey, hey, hey. Hallelujah. There is none like you, God. Yes, raise your voice. Appreciate it. The Lord has saved you from high blood pressure. The Lord has saved you from barrenness. The Lord has delivered you from the captives. From the captive of the wicked, from the affliction of the ungodly. Hey, hey. There is none like you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you. We thank you. Lift up your voice and begin to appreciate him. The unchangeable changer. The game changer. The Bible says that the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it. And they are saved. There is no any other name that has been given. That man can be saved. Under the heavens. Thank him for his name. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Your name is a game changer. Somebody say, Jesus. Jesus. Say, to you be all glory. Jesus. Whenever I call your name, whenever I call your name, you make a way. Makabo Shata. Your name is a game changer. Ah, change. Sing it one more time. Your name is a game changer. Say, Jesus. Say, to you be all the glory. You be all glory. Whenever I call your name, you make a way. So you be all the glory, Lord. Jesus, I want you to lift up your voice and thank him for the strength that he has supplied to you. Thank him for being your help. Thank him for being your succor. The Bible is speaking in the book of Hebrews, chapter 4 and verse 16. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we might obtain mercy, and we will find help in time of need. Lift up your voice and begin to appreciate him. Thank him, thank him. Your name is a game changer. Hey, Jesus. To you be adored, Jesus. Whenever I call the name, you make a way. Just lift up your voice. Begin to appreciate him for his God. All by himself. Thank him for his greatness. His greatness in your life. His protection, His provision. Thank you. He alone is God. Thank you for the pardon of sin that you and I have obtained this last couple of days that we have been before Him, lifting up our voice for our family. Appreciate Him for the safe arrival into another day. It's a day of blessing. I want you to stay awake. Please stay awake. Lose yourself from that sleep. Hallelujah. Lord, we thank you for the increase, divine visitation, testimony of a transformed life that we are receiving. Thank you for visitation. Thank you for encounter. Thank you for revelation. In the name of Jesus. Father, right now, we come according to Psalm 115 verse 1. Now unto us, O Lord, but unto your name, we give glory for your mercy and your truth. Let there be an intervention of your mercy, of your mercy, of your mercy for our family, for our lineage. Open your mouth and pray for your kids. The generation that is on board, Lord, we plead for your mercy. Job prayed for his children. Lift up your voice, pray for your own children, your own lineage, your own generation, using yourself as a point of contact, as a representative. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus. I lift up my voice and I declare your lordship over my lineage, your lordship over my family. Lord, I declare your lordship over my seed, over my descendant, over my family, over the male, over the female, over the baby forever. Lord, I declare your lordship over my family. I declare that your power in the name of Jesus is at war in our land. In the name of Jesus, I speak the word of God by the power of the Holy Ghost. I speak, O God, upon their life according to Nehemiah chapter 4 verse 14. And I look and I rose and I said unto the noble and unto the ruler, the rest of the people, be not afraid of them. Remember the Lord, which is great and terrible, and He will fight for your brethren. He will fight for your son. The Bible speaking in the book of Nehemiah chapter 4 verse 14. Lord, we declare your lordship over our sons, over our daughters, the wives, the husband that will come into our house. Use this scripture. Pray for your future in-law, your future sons in-law, your future sons. Pray for the generation on board. Pray so that you will not pray. Pray so that your memory will be sweet. I want you to settle it once and for all. I declare your lordship over the sons, over the daughters, over the wives, over the husband that will come into this lineage. I declare in the name of Jesus, your lordship, your lordship, your lordship. In the name of Jesus, I speak that they will remember, they will serve the Lord. In the name of Jesus, my children will not miss road in marriage. I speak in the name of Jesus, they will be happy girl. Are you praying? Are we praying? Are you praying? I reject them to marry to Nabal in the name of Jesus. I refuse them to marry to Jezebel in the name of Jesus. They will not marry Delilah. I reject the lie of Nabal, the lie of Jezebel, the lie in the name of Jesus of Delilah in my lineage. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I declare they will not miss it in marriage. I speak the word of God upon their life. My sons are blessed. My daughters are blessed. Their wife, their husband. Pray, pray. The male in my lineage, they are blessed. They are priests forever before the Lord. After the order of Melchizedek, I declare your lordship, your lordship over my lineage. I program them for success. I program them in the name of Jesus. I bless them with the blessing of heaven. They will go from strength to strength. My sons, my daughters, their wife, their husband. I pray for the male, for the female in my family. They are the blessed generation. Akapari Sota, in the name of Jesus. You will have your own children. That's what you are saying. You will never be barren. I rebuild that spirit of barrenness. I come out. Fruitfulness. Fruitfulness. The womb of their destiny is strengthened. They are getting results. The womb of their destiny, I strengthen it. They are winner. They are winner. They are winner. They are not a failure. I speak generational blessing upon my lineage, upon myself, upon my husband, upon my sons, upon my daughters, upon their wives, upon their husband, in our house. People don't die young. I program them to succeed. I program them to be rulers. I program them to be at the top. To be at the top. To be at the top. The lordship of the Lord, I declare, according to Genesis 49:26, as Joshua and Joseph, he prevailed by the blessing. I declare my lineage, they are prevailing. They are prevailing. They are prevailing. My sons, my daughters, their wives, their husbands, they prevail. Look at this. My children will prevail. And by this blessing, I prevail. They prevail. Their father prevail. We prevail. My family, they prevail. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. That amazing thing that the Lord is using this series to do. If you sleep now, it's not good. Yes. Get up and let us pray. Our generation must be blessed. Listen, the next generation through you, they must be settled. And that's what we are saying. Look at the life of Joseph. By the blessing, the Bible says that it prevailed. Listen, I'm going to show you some things today. Blessing make you to prevail. Blessing empower you. Thank God for the testimony of a transformed life that we are hearing. People calling their parents and their parents are blessing them. Issues are coming out. I'm telling you, that is the best testimony that anybody can ever have. That woman did not go into the grave being bitter. I'm telling you, it's a wonderful testimony. What we are hearing, our parents are blessing. For those of us that still have them alive, I'm telling you, during this time, it's a new start in your life. It's a new start in your life. Where others travail, I pray for your children. I pray for your descendants, your sons and your daughters. They will prevail. They will prevail. They will prevail. My people, do you not know that the blessings that come from your parents, whether your parents in the Lord, whether your biological parents, or whether people that are in authority over you, listen and hear me this morning. The blessing that they give you, it can make you to prevail. Thank God for yourself, you can pray. I tell you, I know I said that before. Nobody bless themselves by themselves. It takes a higher authority. One word that they say, it goes a long way. Especially the fathers. There is the priest anointing that God has committed into their hand. Look at what happened in that Genesis. Genesis 49. We are starting on a good note. Your children will prevail. Your lineage will prevail. Your sons and daughters, they will prevail. Whether it is convenient for the devil or not, in the name of Jesus, where others travail, I pray for you as you will say amen. You will prevail. You will prevail over sickness, over stagnation, over limitation, over delay, over death, over sickness, over death, in the name of Jesus, over non-achievement. I see your children. I see your lineage. They are prevailing. They are prevailing. They are prevailing. Raise up your voice and shout seven loud amen. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, look at this. The Bible says we saw Joseph. He prevailed by the blessings of his father. The priest is sent as a father. Did you hear what I've just said? I'm going to be giving some priestly blessing. Yes, by the blessings that I have received from my husband this morning. Yes, being the father of this pastor is the one that God commissioned this ministry into his hand. I only just stand beside that anointing. I only just stand at the back of that calling to begin to function in that calling. So I want you this morning, not just to look at me that I'm the one praying. Yes, I may be the one leading, but I have the backing of God the Father, and I have the backing of the Father that God has committed this platform into his hand. Listen, a child prevailed by the blessing of their father. I will show you in the scripture. It is biblical. God has given them the priest's role so that they will function on behalf of God. Go to your father if he's still alive. I'm telling you, call your spiritual father. Let them bless you. People that are in authority, let them release a word of blessing. Joseph did not prevail by certificate. He did not prevail by hard work. The scripture says, and I will show you, Genesis 49, 26, the blessings of what? Of your father have prevailed above the blessings of who? Of your progenitors, meaning your ancestors, people that have been in your family before now. As you will bless your own sons, yes, that's what we are picture, the picture that we are praying. You pray for your son, call them, don't just let them greet you. When they wake up today, lay hands on them, bless them. If they are at a distance, if you can call them now, call them, release your blessing often upon them. This is what we are teaching. It's different from just praying. Blessings can be provoked. That's why you, that you're an adult, you've got to do something to provoke the blessing of your parents. Don't incur their cause. Don't let them curse you. Don't let them be bitter. Listen, when a parent is bitter against his children, the repercussion of it is a closed heaven. Can I pray for you today? In the name that is above every other name, the blessings of your father, the blessings of your mother, the blessings of your parent, it will prevail. It will prevail. It will prevail. The blessing that you are giving your children, I command today, it will prevail. In the name of Jesus, they will rise up. They will rise up. They will rise up. In the name of Jesus. I love this scripture. It answers so many questions. Since we started this series, a lot of people have been calling. Some we call for prayers. Some we call that, ma, I don't really understand. What is this? What is that? And we have been extra busy than usual. Just because people want answer. Listen, what is troubling your life? It may be your headiness. It may be your stubbornness. It may be that giddiness that you have refused to let go and to submit. But as you humble yourself and you pick up that phone and you call them and they bless you, it doesn't matter whether they are believers or not. You need their blessing. I pray today, the blessing of your father, it will make you to prevail. The blessing of your progenitors into the uttermost bound of everlasting me. They shall be, look at this, they will be on the head of Joseph and on the crown of the head of him that was separated from his brethren. Do you know what that means? By blessing you prevail. I pray for you today, you that you are hearing my voice, in the name that is above every other name, use this prayer that I will be praying. In the name of Jesus, where others are traveling, you will prevail. You will prevail. You will prevail. Every effect of generational curse upon your life, upon your lineage, as you are saying amen, that curse come to an end. It come to an end. It come to an end. Nobody die young in your family. Nobody will die young in the name of Jesus. Every evil that run in your family is turned to good. It's turned to good. It's turned to good. Listen, in your family, you don't bury children. Are we together? You don't bury. In the name of Jesus, in your lineage, you don't bury children. In the name of Jesus, I speak over your life. In the name of Jesus, that the devil, he has nothing to take in your family. In the name of Jesus, I refuse the devil to lay a demand over your life, over your destiny. In the name of Jesus, your days are being wounded. Your days of being wounded is over. In the name of Jesus, from today, you are stepping into the realm of power, the realm of strength, the realm of energy. Give me a loud amen. In the name of Jesus, say to yourself, I am stepping into the realm of power. My lineage, my family, we are stepping into the realm of power, of power. It is time for all to move into liberty. It is time for us to move into our Kenya. It is time for us to move into a land flowing with me and with honor. I declare an encounter with power in the name of Jesus. God will use my generation, my family, to set a standard in the name of Jesus. Pray, 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 pray. Yes. God will use your family in that community, in that school. God will use them to set a standard. I need you to put that up in your DP today. Your children, they will become a point of reference. Makayara, you are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. Your relatives from today, they are blessed. They are blessed. The devil will not take advantage in your family in the name of Jesus. Romans 10:11. We're doing something great this morning. Yes. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. To you be all the glory, Jesus. Whenever I call your name, you make a way. Your name is a strong tower, Jesus. Romans 10:11. I declare in the name of Jesus, the Bible says, whosoever believeth on him will not be ashamed. I speak this scripture upon your lineage. You will not be ashamed. Ah, you will not be ashamed. Stretch your hand. Let me stand in agreement with you. With the backing of the man of God in this house, I speak upon your life in the name of Jesus. You will not see shame. You will not see shame in your family. You will not see shame in the name of Jesus. Isaiah 40:31. No more weaklings in your family. Amen. Nobody will be weak. Amen. Nobody will be tamsy. In the name of Jesus. Pastor Michael was sharing with me a testimony that was shared by Sid Rod. I know majority of us know him. The man that always do like a commentary on the supernatural. His program is called The Supernatural. And he said he always take communion. We are going to take communion again this morning. Listen, throughout the pandemic, this is what we were eating. One of the five things that God told us to do on this platform is for us to eat that communion. And we did it consecutively. For those that were part of this platform, you testify. A woman that had a granddaughter that was sick, she began to minister this communion to this baby. Listen, this was a very young girl. And after the pandemic, they took this same child sample to the hospital for a check. Every traces of sickness that was in her life before then, everything has jacked back to her. Can I pray for you this morning as we partake out of the communion in the name that is above every other name? I speak life. I speak life. I speak life. I speak life in the name of Jesus. In the book of Isaiah 40:31. Isaiah 40:31 says, but they that wait upon the Lord, they will renew their strength. They will mount up wings as eagles. They will run and not be weary. They will walk and not faint. I pray for you and your lineage and your family as together we will partake out of this communion. I declare in the name of Jesus, you are mounting up. Amen. Your children mount up. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Like an eagle. Yes, like an eagle. Yes, like an eagle. Amen. Like an eagle. Amen. When they run, they will not be weary. Amen. When they walk, they will not fail. Amen. shining light that shineth more unto a perfect day. I declare this scripture upon your life, upon your lineage, upon your sons, upon your daughter. You will not walk in darkness. Amen. In the name of Jesus, every darkness around your life, it clears away. It clears away. Are you typing that in? In the name of Jesus. For the scripture says in the book of Isaiah chapter 60 verse 1, it says, arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. As you are saying amen, the glory of God is risen upon your lily. It's risen. It's risen. It's risen. No more darkness. Darkness will not overtake your family. The work of darkness is destroyed in your lineage. It is destroyed in your descendant, in your son's life, in your daughter's life, in your family. It is destroyed in the name of Jesus. Isaiah 54 verse 17. He says, no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against thee in judgment, every ancestral voice, every ancestral sin, whatever your father, whatever your mother, they join witchcraft, but it is not you. They did something evil. You were not part of it. I pray today using this scripture, no weapon that is formed or fashioned against your children, against your sons, against your daughter, it will not prosper. It will not prosper. Every judgment in the name of Jesus, ancestral embargo, ancestral judgment, I condemn it. I cancel 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 it for your life. It is canceled. It is canceled. It is canceled. Say amen. I pray with Job 1:19 for your lineage today. Something must change a curse to a blessing, because the Lord liveth, and as his spirit is alive, I declare. And he says, behold, there will come a great wind from the wilderness, and it will smite the four corners of the earth, and it will fall upon who? Upon the young men, and they shall what? They shall be dead. But I only, I am escaped alone to tell. Listen, there is an escape. There is an exemption for your lineage. There is an exemption from today. Your family is exempted. Whatever wrong in your family that is not godly, please say amen where you are. Don't sleep. Oh, if I'm praying like I'm praying for you, I need you to back up with an amen. I pray in the name of Jesus, you are exempted. Your sons and your daughter, they are exempted. They are exempted from family failure. They are exempted from marital failure. They are exempted from stagnation, from limitation. They are exempted. Evil that run in your family, your children are exempted. In the name of Jesus, there is an escape from that evil. In the name of Jesus. In the book of Philippians, Philippians 4:19, it says, but the Lord, he will supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I declare El Shaddai, he will be the God in your family. El Shaddai God, he will supply all your need in the name of Jesus from today. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I use Psalm 90 verse 14 to pray for you. Listen, in some family, people are delayed. People are delayed. You can agree with me where you are right now that already there is a sign of delay. Majority of people in life, especially as from a family that is Africa, you are delayed already by default of the family or the kind of family that you are born into. There is delay because the father didn't make it. The mother tried everything. She sold everything, but she was not able to make it. And you see that resemblance again running in your family. I'm using this 90 verse 14 of Psalm to pray over your lineage from today. In the name of Jesus, your own children, your own son, your own daughter, I pray their wife, their husband, yes. You will be satisfied. Early. Yes. Anointing of early satisfaction. Yes. Receive it now. Yes. You will not be delayed. Yes. You will not be delayed. Yes. Delay in getting job. Yes. Delay in going to college. Yes, delay in settling. Yes, delay in marriage. Yes, delay in bearing for. Yes, delay in making it. Yes. In life. Yes, you are exempted. Amen. That's it. You are exempted. Amen. You are exempted. Amen. Your lineage is exempted. Amen. Receive that anointing. Amen. For early. Amen. Satisfaction. Amen. Receive it. Amen. I bless you. Amen. With the God of heaven. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You will be settled. Amen. On time. Amen. You will make it. Amen. On time. Amen. In the name. Amen. Of Jesus. Amen. I speak the word of God. Of Exodus 23:26. You are delayed in bearing, but your children will not be delayed. In the name that is above every other name, I pray this prayer from the bottom of my heart. Everybody that is on this platform, in the name that is above every other name, Exodus 23:26, they shall nothing cast their young, nor be barren in thy land. The number of your day I will fulfill. It becomes an expression. It becomes a reality in your lineage. In the name of Jesus, nobody will be barren. In the name of Jesus, they will not cast forth. They are young. The number of your days, of your son, of your daughter, daughter-in-law, son-in-law, the number of their days, they shall fulfill. My goodness, they shall fulfill. You don't know what we are doing. If you will know it, your amen will be the loudest. One of our sisters shared how she called her mother, and this woman had been wounded. Little that did she know, she just called her. She said, "Mama, pray for me." Out of this series that we started, as she called, the woman said, "I have not cursed you, but you have caused me to cry. The cry that I've cried is more than for me to curse you." You can imagine that. And she said, "Mama, you are not where I am now. I'm far away in Europe, but I kneel down and I beg you, whatever I have done, please, Mama, please, Mama." And the woman said, "It's okay, my daughter. I have forgiven you." Listen, I'm telling you, in the name of Jesus, there are wounds that is not expressed as a curse. Sometimes it's inside. You don't see it. There are people you have offended. They have not said a word, but inside they are cursing you. They have not raised a voice, but they are cursing you. So also blessing can be provoked. I want you to provoke the blessing. Provoke the blessing and not the curse. Today I pray in the name of Jesus, in your lineage, nobody will cast their joy. Listen, in your family, you don't bury children. No. Are we together? The Bible says the number of your days you will fulfill. You will not use your hand to bury any of your children, any of your sons, any of your daughter, your daughter-in-law, your son-in-law. They will not die before you. Lift up your voice. Give me three loud amen.
Amen.
The Bible says in Haggai chapter 2 verse 9, what we are doing is like something that will live beyond you. This prayer that we are praying, listen, it will outlive you. When you have gone, it will still be working. Are we together? It will outlast you. This prayer that we are praying, it will last to your posterity. In the name of Jesus, the scripture says in Haggai chapter 2 and verse 9, it says that the glory of this latter house, I don't care, you may have seen shame before now in your lineage, but I pray this scripture, Haggai 2:9, into that your family, you were raped, something happened, you were molested, but it will not happen to your children. In the name of Jesus, you were jilted, you were disappointed, but with your children, listen, these things run. I've seen suicide running in the family. I've seen alcohol running. It has a way from the teaching that I had from the mouth of the man of God and what I have seen in life. I see this thing having a way of just crippling him. Your father died young, but you will live long. Amen. Your mother died young, but you will live long. Amen. In the name of Jesus, even Jesus was 33 years old when he died. He died young so that you will live long. Are you typing that in? He died young. Listen, his own death certificate, it became your own birth certificate. I pray for your children. Nobody will die. You won't bury your children. You won't bury your children. You won't bury your your children. You won't bury your children. You won't see shame. You won't see reproach in the name of Jesus. The Bible says the glory of the latter house, it shall be greater than the former. Yes, meaning that your children will be a better version of you. Where you have a stumbling block, it will become what? Their own stepping stone. Where you have been messed up, there we have a mercy. Where you see ridicule, there we experience a miracle. Are you saying amen where you are? Amen. I see destiny being transformed. Amen. I see life being changed by this prayer. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Wow, wow, wow. Yes, the glory of this latter house. The Bible says it shall be greater than the former. I want to run and tell you about this new beginning blessing. What is it exactly that we are talking about when we are talking of this blessing? Tomorrow, you don't want to miss it. By the grace of God, we'll be back again. Myself and Pastor Michael, with this declaration upon your life, you don't want to miss it. Please, if you are under a man of God or a woman of God, don't despise what we are saying. People are calling and they are testifying of what God is doing with this word of prayer that God is doing. A man that God helped, a building that has been there and has not been yielded for a very long time in years. This very series that we started, huge amount of money was being paid. People are competing to take the vacant house. I'm praying for you today. Yes, whatever has not been working, yes, I want you to watch the space. Yes, what did I say? Watch the space. Coming soon, yes. Put that up. Watch the space. Just tell somebody that greets you today. Say, Damilola, I'm telling you, watch the space. Coming soon. Appearing real in the name of Jesus. Amen. What does it mean? All this that we have been saying. I want to take you through scriptures and show you, because I know people have a different perspective in this regards of what we are saying. I'm going to talk to you in the next few minutes on the power of blessing. As a curse has power, so also blessing has a power. Listen and hear me, people of God. The power of blessing cannot be underestimated. I'm telling you, a blessing. Somebody asked me yesterday, said, "Ma, what does it mean?" A blessing is a provocation. A blessing is an impartation. A blessing is a pronouncement. A blessing is a word that is issued upon you. Listen, it may not be a long prayer. It may be just one word. I remember somebody sharing with me, after she blessed the father, the father blessed Abba and said, "Daughter, I don't have any prayer for you." And the father said, "Listen, even when he has died," he said, "anytime you have a memory of me," he said, "just be saying amen." Because on his way to heaven, this man is talking now, listen, he said, on his way to heaven, he's still praying for this daughter. What have you done to provoke the blessing of your spiritual parent? What have you done to provoke the blessing of your father, of your mother? Listen, you need it. Nobody rises without being blessed. I'm telling you, you see people that are smart. We see people that are educated. Not by the education, by a pronouncement. We saw that in the life of Joseph, where we started from, in the book of Genesis that we saw. You see, his head was lifted. How was his head lifted? By the blessing. He said he prevailed. His head prevailed. Listen, the blessing of your parent is like a crown on your head. The blessing of your parent is like the icing on your cake. The blessing on your parent is what come to consolidate your own prayer, and then boom, something explode and it begins to work. You need it. What is this power of blessing? Look at it. Let me show you. When the blessing of God comes upon your life, you become unusually productive. That's what we see in that Genesis 49:26. You become what? Unusually productive. When your mother blesses you, I'm telling you, even the witch, when they curse you, it will not work. Haven't you seen people that they are prayed and the prophetess tell and the prophet, they say, "Go to your parents. Go and make way. Go." What did that angel say to Hagar? He said, "Where are you from?" He said, "I'm from my mistress." He said, "Go back. Go back." I wonder every time I read that scripture, when Agai left, why will she leave? Why will she leave? Because Sarah told her to leave. There was a vendetta. There was a problem there. She left. But the angel, with the angel not know, but still the angel said, "Go back." Go back in the book of Genesis, if you can pull that scripture out from. He said, "Go back to Sarah, your mistress." Why? There is a blessing. People that are over you. Pastor Pastor Michael was teaching me yesterday. He said it's not just your spiritual parent. It's not just your biological parent. Even people that have authority, the elders, who have you wronged in your family? And now you are thinking they are wicked elders. No, you did something. You need to calm down. You need to humble. You need to surrender and say, God, forgive me. Lord, I won't do this again. That was what this woman that shared the testimony with me. He said the mother kept raging. She said, Mama, I'm on my knee. It won't happen again. Please forgive me. No matter what the woman said, she told me, according to her, when she called, she said it was difficult. No matter how I tried, my mother just kept saying, no, don't you know what you have done? And she said, no. She didn't know that she has even hurt this woman. Little did she know, she is even thinking that she's right because of what her mother done to her. Listen, when they do injustice to you, it is not for you to talk. It is for God to judge it. But it is for you to do the right thing that is expected of you. Hallelujah. And God said unto Abraham, let it not be grievous in your sight because of the lad and because of the bondwoman, in all that Sarah has said unto thee, hearken unto her voice, O hearken, listen to what she, for in Isaac shall your seed be called. In Isaac, not in Ishmael. I have a covenant with you, Abraham. So listen. What I'm showing you is the power of obedience when it comes to blessing. Oh, wow, our time is gone. When the blessing of God comes upon your life, you become unusually productive. You cannot be like other people. Where other people suffer, you triumph. Genesis chapter 1 verse 28. When man was created, I looked at it. God did not give us a clothes. He did not give us, car. No. He did not give us money. He gave us blessing. Listen, if you are a child of God and you are blessed, and you are born again, you are blessed because you have spiritual blessing. It's there already. Once you give your life to Christ, thank God. We all have this spiritual blessing. Listen, but all these categories of blessing have different role of what they play in our life. Yes. Spiritual blessing has the power to tell you that you are blessed to have eternal life. Yes, but while you are still here on earth, listen, there are blessings that you need from people that are in authority. Your parent, your spiritual parent. Genesis 1:28, be fruitful and multiply. Look at that. God said, be fruitful. Yes, replenish the earth, subdue it. Have dominion over fish and over the sea and over the fowl of the air and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. The blessings of God, it impacts a supernatural force for the commencement of a new beginning. We talk about new beginning. New beginning don't just happen until a blessing, a force, a supernatural force, it is released. One of the most forces on earth is the forces of blessing. I'm telling you, my sister, my brother, my time is gone, but give me 3 minutes, I'll be done. Listen, the most powerful forces on earth is the forces of blessing. The blessing of God is behind the making of anybody. Nobody is made without blessing. I've never seen anybody that is made with a curse. That's what I'm saying to you. The blessing of God is behind the making, but in the scripture and in the contemporary, men like Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, Joseph, Job, we saw how the blessings of God made their life. What is the power of blessing? The blessing imparts a supernatural force for a new beginning. When your children are born, why is it that the priests come and bless them? Have you ever thought of it? It's a new beginning for them. When we name in our own sector, yes, it is scriptural and it is biblical. On the 8th day, yes, on this platform where we are, in our own part of Dropton, as part of our tenet of faith, when our children are born, we bless them on the 8th day. We release blessing. It's an impartation for a new beginning. I see also, when children are going to school, they are resuming back now. Some have resumed. You need to bless them. Don't let them go carelessly. Also, on the day of their graduation, on the day that they are doing settling in life, on the day that they are getting married, they need it. It's an impartation of a new beginning. The blessing imparts the supernatural force for the commencement of a new beginning. It is very important. The blessing imparts a supernatural force for the activation of the potential, of the exhibition of productivity. That's why the Bible says, be fruitful and multiply. What does that mean? Be productive. be pro. These are things you need to speak over your children. These are things that you need to speak. It is an impartation, an activation. They already carry it, but by you pronouncing it, then it is activated. Wow. Thank God for this series. The blessing of God impart a supernatural force that position people for a generational influence. You don't have influence unless you are being blessed. Genesis 1:28, it says replenish the earth. Replenish. To replenish means you are influential. You take over. The blessings of God makes you a force that must be reckoned with. Also, the blessing of God position you into the realm of dominion, into the realm of authority. You will be sleeping, they will come and press you. Nothing will happen. You are still strong. Genesis, that same Genesis 1:28. The blessings of God make you to be a woman and a man of influence. The Lord bless you. Cause his face to shine upon you. What do you do? Three things. Number one, be determined to function in the blessings of God. Number two, make demand of the blessings of God to be released. Make demand of the blessing of your parents. Don't just call them today. And no. Make it an occasion. I look at it when you are calling them. What have you done for them? For them to bless you, that blessing will be provoked. You don't just collect blessing with empty mouth. No, you do something. That is the one that is provoked. It's an act felt because you have touched them. If you are a church member and you are wounding your pastor, you are wounding him and you are doing something that will injure him. If he pray, it's just an empty word. What have you done? What is your impact in the ministry that can provoke your blessings to be activated? That's exactly what we are saying. Make up your mind today to provoke the blessing. Don't do it once. Do it all the time. Send money for them to eat. Your father, yes, at home. Your mother. Make sure that they don't live in hunger. When they die and you are going to kill 10 cows, those cows will be chasing you in the dream. Because while they are alive, they were hungry. You didn't give them food. They needed money. You didn't give them. Now they die. You went and bring a band to start singing. And while they were alive, you didn't take care of them. No, it doesn't work that way. Make up your mind to demand their blessing. And make sure you always demand it. Call them up to pray for me. Why are you calling? Say nothing, Baba. Baba, just pray for me. I need your prayer. And then do it occasionally also. Be involved in the practice of the covenant that will attract the blessings of God. We have come to the end of today's broadcast. I know somebody has been blessed. Call that number +35387611841. Let us know how this program has blessed you. A lot of calls has come in. We have not physically had testimony, headache, stomach, but we have testimony of a life change. People being impacted by their parental blessing. Yours also is on the way. It's a new day for you in the name of Jesus Christ. If God has ministered to you, please repost this video. Let somebody be blessed. As you're going out, look at people that must be blessed in your lineage, your brother, your sister. Send it to people and God will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. There is a program coming this Saturday by the grace of God from the hours of 11. The guest speaker is Pastor Mayowa Ajayi. Strength from above. Don't miss it. And God will bless you in Jesus' name. September fasting and prayer is fast approaching. All throughout the month of September, from the 1st to 30th, we are going to be engaging in a fast. Join us and your life will never remain the same. Sunday service. Wow. King's Church. God bless us in Jesus' name. Reaching your eyes. We are going higher. We are reaching our best. In the name of Jesus. The tickets are sold out again by the grace of God. But we are going to still continue to wait on God for what God wants us to do. Please, at this time, I want you to be online. If you are not able to secure a seat, please make sure you are online to be part of the first service and the second service. And God bless you. Tomorrow is going to be hot. Please get your children to be part of tomorrow's morning prayer. And God bless you. On your way to work, you are blessed. Heaven door is open for your sake in Jesus' name. I'll see you tomorrow morning. Until then, remain blessed in Jesus' name. Amen.